the biggest mistakes in Psychopharm, you were expecting to hear us to say never mix in MAOI and an SSRI and Demerol, right?
Yeah.
But the biggest mistakes are sometimes the littlest ones we make the most often, and that's kind of the recurring theme here. But I think one of the biggest mistakes we're going to make is we pick the wrong drug first.
Yeah.
It's a pharmacodynamic failure. We can't read minds or brains. And again, when a drug is dosed right, you get the pharmacokinetics right, and you max it out, you got to move on, follow treatment guidelines, push the next one. Yeah. So we picked the wrong drug.
Yeah.
Just, you got to be flexible and move on. Don't hang out in a drug with a drug that's not working.
Yeah. And I like to say there's some forms of depression that are not necessarily serotonin responsive. You know, so don't keep slamming SSRI after SSRI. Sometimes that can work, but not as often as you might think.
So I want to have a conversation here because I sat in the audience all week and I was told by a great lecturer, you know, particularly with schizophrenia, something about 2 weeks.
I don't know who said that.
2 weeks, push the dose. Why are you waiting 3, 4, 5, 6? And another great lecturer, maybe Dr. McIntyre for antidepressants, right?
Yep.
And maybe 4 weeks, 2 weeks, 4 weeks. But we didn't talk about PTSD, OCD, and other. This is flagged for you, but we can all answer. How long do you wait for the other disorders?
I think data is converging that if you're not seeing at least a 25% improvement in the first 2 weeks, time to do something. And what that something is raise the dose, augment, switch. And that's where your clinical judgment comes in. But it's very rare for these drugs to not work, not work, not work, and at week 6 magically start working. Drug response typically is more of a gradual process. So I think that we, even though we're classically trained, wait 4, 6, 8 weeks, well, what's happening during that time? What's happening to your patient during that time? I think in some cases, time is brain. There may literally be damage being done to the brain. Now, that being said, this is a very classic curve that you see. I've done a lot of clinical trials, as you know, and a lot of times when you look at longer-term studies, what you see is a relatively rapid improvement over the first few weeks, and then it levels off, but it continues to improve over time. And this is certainly true in the antipsychotic world, and it could be that there are some things that continue to happen a little more gradually over time in the brain that are positive. There's more adaptation happening over time. So I'm a fan of continuing.
But the idea, if you can go back to that graph, please, is that, as Dr. Cutler said, it's very rare that you've got nothing and then you'll get extra. And the rule of thumb is if you have nothing in the first 2 weeks, you're unlikely to be a responder at week six. But if you get anything, and what's 25% improvement, that's usually about one CGI severity point. All you're looking for is the patient to say, I feel a bit better. That's it. That's all I want to know.
Yep.
And it's like, fine, we're going to let you roll for another month and we'll
on
see what
right
you
track.
Get.
On the
and
right
if, in the world of mood disorders, the name of the game is remission. If you're not in remission, then you'll continue to make decisions. I very rarely put people into remission in schizophrenia, so it's a bit different.
And also, this is where clinical judgment comes in. You mentioned these other disorders. If somebody's acutely suicidal, obviously my time frame changes there. I need to be more aggressive. I can't have the luxury of waiting. So.